Myself Sandesh NG, Assistant Professor, Department of EC, MIT Mysore. The subject is Verilog HTL, the subject code 18EC56. So here Verilog HTL, the name indicates it's a type of programming language. So here the HTL stands for Hardware Description Language. In HTL, classified into two languages, one is Verilog HTL, then another one is VHTL. VHTL stands for VHSIC, then HDL. VHSIC means Very High Speed Integrated Circuits, Hardware Description Language. So in our syllabus, we discuss only on Verilog HTL. Before going to subject, this Verilog HTL, first we discuss some basics of Verilog HTL, basic needs of Verilog HTL. Why? Because of here, throughout this Verilog HTL concepts, we design a digital circuits, that is digital system design. So that's why we need some basics of digital electronics as well as digital system design. We start with gates. Gates can be classified into three types. One is basic gates, another one is special gates, universal gates. So here the basic gates, three types of basic gates here. One is AND gate, another one is OR gate, then NOT gate. For special, two gates, one is XOR, another one is XNOR. There are two universal gates, one is NAND, another one is NOR gate. We need to know all these gates in detail. So first we consider basic gates. First one, NOT gate. First we write the symbol of NOT gate. This is the symbol of NOT gate. Let us assume one input, then as well as one output. So once you mention the input and output, next we write the logic, that is using truth table. Then A is the input, Y is the output, then A is equal to 0, then Y is equal to 1. When you applied A is equal to 0, then we getting output side Y is equal to 1. Then you applied A is equal to 1, then we getting Y is equal to 0. So based on this truth table, we have to write the equation. So the equation can be written as Y is equal to A complement, we called as Y is equal to A bar. So here, based on this equation, using this equation, we have to write the programming, that is Verilog code later. Okay, first we studied this NOT gate, then next move on to second one, AND gate. First again we write the symbol of AND gate. So there are two inputs here, we assume A and B, then one output, it's again we consider it's Y. Then next we write the truth table for this gate. Here the name indicates AND gate. So first assume 0 0. Here there are four combinations here. First 0 0, then output is 0, then 0 1, output is 0, then 1 0, then output is 0, then 1 1, then finally getting output is 1. So here any one of the input is 0, and that time output is equal to 0. Then only one condition, all the inputs are I, and that time only the output is equal to 1. So the after this truth table, we just mark the what, when the output is equal to 1, then and write the equation here, Y is equal to A and B, or we simply write Y is equal to A B or A dot B, like this. So here getting the equation, that is Y is equal to A B, then we can possible to write the Verilog code for this one. Next, third one, OR gate. This is the symbol of OR gate. Two inputs A and B, then Y, then write the truth table. Again here four combinations, it's similar to AND gates. So first combination, if it is 0 0, then output is 0. If it is 0 1, output is 1. Then 1 0, output is 1. Then 1 1 1, the output is equal to 1. Speciality of OR gate here, the any one of the input is high and that time output is equal to 1. This is the what a OR gate. Next, move on to special gates. The first special gate we have to consider, XOR gate. This is the logic symbol, then A and B is the input, then Y is the output. Next, we write the truth table. A, B, then Y. Then first, again similar to what previous gates, that is OR and there are four combination here, 0 0, then if it is 0 0 1 it's 1, then 1 0 1, then 1 1 it's 0. Just observe the truth table here. Why we called as special gates? Because here the condition when all the inputs are either low or high, all the inputs, and that time only it's logic 0. If any one of the input is complement, for example A is equal to 0, then B is equal to 1. Suppose A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, and that time only the output is what? Logic 1. So based on this output we write the equation, that is Y is equal to here first one, A bar B, that is A complement B, plus then this is the what OR gate, then next one A bar B, then A B bar. So here just observe the equation. So compared to previous equations, it's little bit complicated, because here when you complement the what A, one NOT gate is required. When you complement the B, one more NOT gate, so two NOT gates is required here, then plus two AND gates, A bar B one AND gate, then A B bar another AND gate, then totally 4 plus 1 OR gate. So totally here there are 5 gates are required. So it's very complicated. That's why we just modified this equation, that is A exclusive OR B. So there is a what special XOR gate is there. We can directly write Y is equal to A exclusive OR B. Okay, then next move on to XNOR gate. So XNOR gate, so you just one difference compared to previous XOR gate. So here the complement of the XOR gate here we called as XNOR gate. So this is the symbol of XNOR gate. Then A and B is the input, then Y is the output, then truth table A B Y. When it is 0 0 then it's 1, when it is 0 1 it's 0, 1 0 it's 0, then 1 1 it's 1. So it's exactly opposite of what the previous one XOR gate. So here this is the equation, Y is equal to A bar B bar plus A B. So using this equation, it's very difficult one. Again it requires totally 5 basic gates. So that can be modified using, in terms of you write XNOR, Y is equal to A XNOR B, that is A XNOR B. So using this equation we can possible to write the programming for this equation. Last type of gates, So very important one, universal gates. So first, the definition, why we called as universal gates? Because using this universal gates, we can possible to design any gate. We can possible to design AND gate, we can possible to design OR gate, and also NOT gate, and also we can possible to design a special gates, okay, using universal gates. So universal gates, two universal gates, one is NAND, another one is NOR gate. So first we consider NAND gate. This is the what a symbol of NAND gate. So it's exactly opposite of what AND gates. You just consider AND gate, we just add one inverter or NOT gate at the output side, then it becomes an NAND gate. So here we directly write NAND gate symbol here. Then after this, truth table. Then A and B is the input, then Y is the output. So if it is 0, 0, it's 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Here, this truth table, it's exactly opposite of AND gate. Here, all the inputs are I, and that time the logic 0. So after this, we write the equation for this NAND gate, Y is equal to AB complement. Or we can write is equal to A NAND A NAND B. So this is the what some explanation about NAND gate. Next, move on to next one, NOR gate. So this is the symbol of a simple NOR gate. So it's exactly opposite of this basic gate. So here we can possible to write one OR gate. It's just connected to serial with a NOT gate. Then it becomes an NOR gate. So here this is a symbol of NOR gate. Then truth table A and B 0 0 and that time it's 1. Then 0 1 it's 0. Then 1 0 it's 0. Then 1 1 it's 0. So it indicates when all the inputs are low and that time only the output is logic 1. We write the equation here, then Y is equal to A plus B whole bar, or we write A NOR B. This is the final equation for the NOR gate. We define it's an universal gate. We just prove it the what? The NAND gate or NOR gate. It's just an universal gates. So first we consider, we design AND gate using NAND gate. Okay. Design AND gate using NAND. So this is the what a two NAND gates are required for AND gate here. This is the what a final circuit for AND gate using NAND gate. We just verified this circuit. Write the truth table for the AND gate here. A and B Y 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1. We just verified the here when you applied 0 0 and that time. So we know that NAND gate truth table, when it is 0 0 then it becomes an 1. When you applied 1 1 here then it becomes an 0. So when you applied 0 0 then it becomes an 0 here. Next, take one more reading, that is 1 1. When you applied 1 1 then output is equal to 0 at the NAND gate, again here 0 0, then when you applied 0 0 then output is equal to 1. This is the what? A AND gate circuit using NAND gate. Next, here these are all the what's base gates we have to study: basic gates, then special gates and universal gates. Next, move on to A, we have to design next a digital circuits, digital system design. So here generally two types of digital system design. One is A, we called as combinational circuits, another one is we called as sequential circuit. First we consider a combinational circuits. Combinational circuit, it is defined as the output depends on only a present input. Okay, again I repeat, combinational circuit is defined as the output depends on the present input. So output depends on present input means any changes in input, and that time the output changes quickly. So we called as combinational circuits. Circuit, let us take some examples for combinational circuits. When you design the combinational circuit, on that time you should know the what? All the gates operation. Because when you write the any combinational circuits, the gate is what? Must and should. Gate is required. So combinational circuit, let us take basic circuits. Basic one is off adder. Off adder is the basic circuit. Then we write the first block diagram for off adder. A and B is the input, two inputs here, then sum and carry. Sum and carry is the output. First we write the truth table. So truth table, A and B is the input, then sum and carry is the output. So A and B, when it is 0, 0, then when you add these two 0, 0, then sum is equal to 0, then carry is equal to 0. When 0, 1 is the second combination, when you add 0, 1, then sum is equal to 1, then carry is equal to 0. Next one, 1, 0. 1, 0 you add, then sum is equal to 1, then carry is equal to 0. Then last combination, sum A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, and that time add these two, then sum is equal to 0, but carry is generated. So this is the truth table for a simple off adder. Based on this truth table, we have to write the equations. So here, when these two condition, when it is 0, 1 and 1, 0, then the sum is I. So it can be written as sum is equal to, so here A bar B plus next one A B bar. So you just observe the equations here. So it requires totally 5 gates, 2 NAND NOT gates, then 2 AND gates, 1 OR gate. It's very difficult to implement. So that's why this equation can be modified. So it looks like a XOR gate. So it can be written as A XOR B, that is a sum equation. We have to write the carry equation. Carry is equal to, just observe here, when it is carry is equal to 1, so that is last condition, that is A and B. So A and B, or you can write A and B. This is the what? The final carry equations here. So using this equation, we have to write a programming language, that is Verilog HDL. So this is the one example. So here we have to prove the output is directly proportional to what? Input. Here, when it is 0, 0, 0 only. When you change the one input, that is B is equal to 1, then output is changes quickly. That is sum is equal to 1, then carry is equal to 0. So many combinational circuits available with respect to digital system design. Off adder, then off subtractor, then full adder, then full subtractors. Then these are all the basic adder circuits, and also there is a encoder, there is a decoder, then priority encoder, then without priority, then multiplexer, then we simply called as MUX. It stands for many into one, that is many inputs, then one outputs, then DMUX, it's exactly opposite of a MUX. So many combinational circuits are available with respect to what? A digital system design. So next, second one, sequential circuits. Sequential circuits. So it is defined as the output depends on the present as well as previous one, previous input, or it may be a output. Okay. Again, I repeat this. The sequential circuits is defined as the output depends on present as well as past output or input. So here there are many sequential circuits here. We go with what? A flip-flops. So first one is the basic one, D flip-flop. Then T flip-flop, SR flip-flop, then JK flip-flop, MSJK flip-flops. So these five flip-flops are available with respect to sequential circuits. So here D flip-flop, the D indicates its delay or data flip-flop. Then T flip-flop, we called as it's a toggle flip-flop. Then set or reset are we called as SR and RS. Okay. Then set reset flip-flop. Then JK flip-flop, that is J and means Jack and Kilby, the scientist name, JK flip-flop. Then MSJK flip-flop. So let us consider one example. Okay, with respect to sequential circuit, we take a D flip-flop. We write the D flip-flop truth table. Then D, then Q. Then if you want to complement this one, we write Q bar. Then obviously it's a sequential circuits. We have to assume a clock pulse. Okay. Then either you can assume edge triggered or level triggered. So we always choose edge triggered flip-flop because it changes quickly, but level triggering is the speed is very less. Okay. So that's why we always choose edge triggering. That is, either you assume positive edge triggering or negative edge triggering. So let us assume positive edge triggering. When D is equal to 0, then Q is equal to 0, then Q bar is complement, it's 1. Then again one more clock you applied, that is positive clock pulse. Again when it is 1, then here Q is equal to 1, then Q bar is equal to 0. So this is the what when you apply the positive edge triggering. So when you apply the negative edge triggering, what happens here? When you apply negative edge triggering, so here D either 0 or 1, okay, we call as simply don't care. Either 0 or 1 you applied, then whatever the previous one, that is previous state is repeat here, that is 1 and 0. Okay, so that is previous state is 1 and 0. So it follows the previous state, that is 1 and 0. So this is the what example for sequential circuits. So not only flip-flops, there is more sequential circuits. So counter is there, then shift register is there. So these are all the what the basic needs for a Verilog HDL. So next move on to the what a module 1.